Dialogues and overlays are a fairly common sight on modern web apps, but until recently they had to be built manually using position div elements and other CSS and JavaScript hacks. The HTML 5.2 spec introduced an official dialog element, which is currently supported natively in Chrome and other browsers based on the Blink engine and is under development in Firefox. In this page here, I'll click on the dialog element. This contains information about the new dialog element, and I'll let you read it at your leisure. There's also a polyfill available for browsers that don't yet natively support it. So let's go over to our code. Let's take a look at the finished version of this example in our browser. All right, so here's the finished version, and you can see that when I click on this button, the dialog shows up and I can dismiss it, and that's the non-modal version. And this is the modal version with the page grayed out. And this is this backdrop option that you see here can be styled individually. All right, so let's open the code and build this. So here in VS Code, I'll open up dialog underscore start. And here's my file. And if I scroll down, you can see that the dialog element is defined in HTML right here using the dialog tag. And once I've defined the dialog structure using markup, I have to write some script code to handle showing and closing the dialog in response to the button clicks. So let's fill that in. So when the user clicks the show button, I'm going to show the dialog using the non-modal API. So I'll write document.getElementById. And the dialog has an ID of dialog 1. So I'll get that dialog. And I'll call the show function. And for the modal version, I will simply call show modal instead. All right. And then I'll add the code to close the dialog when the OK and cancel buttons are clicked in the dialog. So I'll write if, and in this case, I need to check to see if the dialog is open by checking the open property. Then I'll call dlg.close. And DLG is right here. We get the same element. And in the close function, I will call this with the value of OK for the OK button. And then for the cancel button, I'll just copy that code and paste it down here. And in this case, I'll call close with the value of cancel instead. All right, so let's try out what we have so far. So we'll bring this up with our live server. And sure enough, you can see there's the dialog. And in this case, you can see it's working, but it doesn't look very good. So we can add some CSS styling to make it look better. So that's the non-modal version. And this is the modal version. You can see that it kind of slightly grays out, but I don't really like that. We can do a better job there. So let's go back to the code. All right, so here in the code, I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to uncomment this style sheet declaration right here. So I'll uncomment that and remove the closing comment there. All right. So the first style sheet defines an appearance for the dialog itself. It has a background color, border radius, shadow, and so on. The next two styles are for the content inside the dialog. There's the H1 that defines the title and the div that contains the dialog content, the text, and the buttons. And the last style defines an appearance for the backdrop, or the shaded part of the page that is not part of the dialog and is only used when the dialog is a modal one. So let's save this and let's go back to the browser and we'll refresh. And now let's bring up the modal dialog again. And there you can see that the dialog appearance has changed along with the shaded backdrop area. All right, there's one more thing to look at, so let's go back to the code. So the values that are passed to the dialog close function are actually available to the rest of the program as return values from the dialog. So dialogs also have a couple of events that your code can listen for, and I'm going to demonstrate both features here. So at the bottom of my script, I have some code that listens for the close and cancel events, which is fired when the escape key is used to cancel the dialog. So what we're going to do is go back to the developer tools and look at the console, because this property here the return value on the dialog element should be given whatever was called into the close function. So when I click the OK button, the string of OK should show up here for the close function. And when I cancel, the string cancel should show up when this value is accessed off the dialog element in this case. So let's go back to the browser and let's bring up the developer tools. All right, so let's go ahead and show the dialog. And when I click OK, you can see the dialog was closed with the OK button. And when I show it with the modal, I'm going to click cancel. And you can see that it was closed with cancel. And rather than clicking, I'll hit the escape key. And there you can see that it was both canceled and closed. So instead of using third-party libraries just to show dialogues, you can now use the built-in feature of HTML.